while the camera manufacturers are well on their way into a resolution and format race, light manufacturers are getting into new territories. Lots of small companies are trying to come up with interestingly new products. In this video, I'm going to talk about such a company, not just a company, a maverick company who's thought about an interesting product and also got not just funded, overfunded by almost 425%. Want to know which that company is? LoupeDeck. Want to know what it is? Well, let's unbox it. Okay, in place. Oops, another one. Hey, come out, my friend. A brand new DJ interface for the music-loving photographer. Jokes apart, this is the brand new physical interface for Lightroom. Sounds interesting? You bet it is. Let's quickly connect it to a computer and see how it works. Over to our setup. Things are getting really interesting in Pixel Village. So I request you to subscribe if you haven't already and hit that bell button so that you get to know whenever we upload our video. So back to our hero today, the LoupeDeck hardware interface for Adobe Lightroom. This is a USB 2 device, and for the computer and the software to understand and recognize the hardware, you have to install a plugin. Very simple, go to LoupeDeck website, click open and go to setup, and you will see a Mac and Windows plugin available right at the bottom of the page. We have already installed it for Mac. So once when you run it, your LoupeDeck icon will appear on the top of the menu bar, right on top. And then you open your Lightroom and Lightroom comes back on. For convenience, we have already selected a set of images and imported them into our selected library. Okay, now to the hardware. This hardware has a set of very clearly demarked primary controls, which are contrast, clarity, shadows, highlights, all your familiar terminologies. It has a set of keyboards using which you can either color tag it or you can rate it using your stars. It has copy, paste, pig zoom, all self-explanatory. It also has a undo button and a redo button. Of course, there's a brush and zoom and a set of scroll buttons. The interface also has a set of custom functions and a set of programmable buttons too. It works effectively in combination with a mouse and the menu. So let's look at how you tag your image. I'm using the cursor key here to shift right, right, right. And now that's my image. I'm going to give it a 5-star. So when I click 5-star and the star rating will appear as usual, right at the bottom of the image. The next one, I'm tagging as I am selecting the image. Okay, let me tag this. And let me also get, oh, this is nice too. Let me pick this. And let me pick this one. I like this. Let me pick this one. Okay, I'd like to recommend two different ways of processing your image. There are certain images that requires only color correction, so-called grading. You need to get your skies right, your exposure right, your sharpness, whites, blacks, highlights, shadows, all that. There are a whole lot of photographers who would like to also retouch their images. To such photographers, I will say, don't do any color grading initially. You make do all your basic corrections, correct your contrast and sharpness and white, whatever that you want to correct, all the primary corrections. Process it into a high-res uncompressed TIFF or JPEG if that's your favorite. Then work on all those images in Photoshop, finish them and bring it back to Lightroom and then grade it, which to me is the most appropriate way, and you will enjoy it. All you need to do is to just get used to this piece of hardware for a little while. I've been using it for the last couple of days, and let me tell you, I've already got hooked onto this. Though I don't now really do a lot of work on my own, now I'm kind of tempted to play with this a little because it's very interesting. One big advantage of working with hardware vis-a-vis working with the menu is that you can see your images in full screen and still make corrections. Because the moment you switch to full screen mode, your menus disappear from your screen. So you will not be able to make any corrections in that case. But here with this hardware, you can go to the full screen preview mode and continue to work, make all those corrections using your hardware interface. So let's take this image. I think the exposure is correct. We need to open up the shadows a bit. So I'm using the shadow button and I'm going to open it up. And if you can see here, shadow is moving by small increments. And then the highlights, I want to bring little information back in the highlights. So turn left, before and after. This is quickly, one on the left is before and on the right is after. Okay, see the difference? Now I need to do the horizon correction. This large button, if you turn it clockwise, can you see it turning? Yeah. If you want to make those changes in smaller increments, keep the function button pressed and turn it, and you will make much more minute corrections. Nice. There are three controls here: hue, saturation, and luminance. If I need to address the blue, I have these wheels here. I shift to saturation, I pick the blue here, and I increase it slowly, and you will see the blue being, oops, that's a little too much. Okay, that's a blue. I also want to let this green pop a bit. So that's my green, and just about that. And the luminance of the green too. And back to saturation, and you see the green popping up. So before, one on the left is before, and one on the right is after. Very simple, straightforward, and ready. If you were to make a correction using the mouse and the keyboard in the conventional way, well, imagine, you have to come here, key in or use the slider. While you do that, just to make sure that it is that exact amount, you will have to look at the menu, and by the time you come back, you will have lost your bearing. Okay? That's where I think this kind of device become more useful, because you can keep your eye planted in your image while making those corrections. So, that about it. I think more or less this image to me is okay. Let me go to another image. Okay, this is an interesting image. Okay, let me open the shadows a little. Okay, the shadows are opening. Now I want to improve the overall saturation. So let me get the saturation pumped up a little. And now I want to pick this yellow. Enhance only the yellow. Okay, so there it is. There's a little bit of blue in the horizon. I may want to touch it a little, not too much. And yes, let's see before. One on the left is before and one on the right is after. And at any point you want to see this image in full screen, press full screen and it loads up as your full screen image. I like to also show you how to use the brush tool with the console. So for which you need to hit the brush, well, for which the console alone cannot do the function. You need the use of the mouse. I'm going to select the bottom from here till here. So see how it's opening up and nicely balanced. Okay. I have now shown you only the primary controls. This console has two more extensions. One is there are three custom control functions which you can assign certain functions to, and then there are a set of preset functions which can be assigned again. Okay, for which I need to open up the LoupeDeck plugin, click on configure, and it opens up a series of options in front of you. These are the customizable buttons and knobs. So let's go to the C1, and you can assign any of these functions for C1. So vignette, noise reduction, dehaze, sharpness. So let me select vignette. Okay, let me go to another image and see what happens in the image. I'm going to use the C1 to add vignette. See that? There's a nice vignette happening. The preset functions are a little different. You may have bought a lot of third-party plugins for your Lightroom, effects, presets, etc. You can assign about 8 of them to these buttons, and at one press of the button, you would be applying that effect onto your image. So what did we all see? We saw the primary controls. We saw the, you know, a whole lot of secondary controls here, the hue, saturation, luma, selective. The secondary controls are using your graduated filters and your brush tools and all that. You also saw how you can assign each buttons, the custom buttons and the preset buttons. You saw the rating, you saw everything. Now what else is remaining? Of course, you did not see color and black and white. Let's go to another image. Okay, this is one image here. Let me convert this into black and white. And it changes to black and white instantly. One big advantage is you can scroll or you can rotate more than one wheel at a time, which is impossible using a mouse and the menu on the side. Before going there, let me tell you, I was always fascinated by the colorist, the color grading artist in the film world. They work with something like this, except that they work on color grading on a motion picture. They have these multiple roller balls and controls and presets controls and all that, which is in a different scale. Of course, they are much more elaborate, big, more expensive. They work on more than one control at time. So when they are increasing the exposure, they will also be pulling, let's say, the highlight. For example, here I am increasing the exposure. At the same time, I'm also pulling the highlights down. It gives you a different feel altogether. This is something which you cannot do. Let me pick the black and the white. Okay, while I am opening the blacks, I am pulling the whites. Okay, it's a different feel altogether. Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying this is the best, but you know, this is the kind of controls that are available. You can do more than one control at a time. One thing I forgot to mention was, at any point you want to go back to the 0-0 position, just tap that down, it'll disappear. All that setting that you did using that button goes back to 0. I'm going to pick another image for convenience. I'm going to increase the exposure. Exposure has gone very high now. No, you don't like it, you want to go to the original 0-0 positions, just press it back, it goes to 0-0. You added saturation. You don't like it, press it, it's gone back. What else? I think we explained almost everything that at least I know at this point about this piece of hardware. And I'm sure since it is controlled by plugin software from the computer, every time the plugin gets upgraded, I'm sure it's going to unleash more capabilities of this piece of hardware. So who's this for? I think this is for that photographer who's really concerned about the color, who wants to do that fine-tuning himself. Also for that designer who designs these exquisite wedding albums. I'm sure he's going to thoroughly enjoy it. Among photographers, the landscape photographer is going to really enjoy. I don't think he's going to leave it very soon. I'm sure he's going to make multiple variations of his one image, because you know there are a lot that you can do with this. The wildlife photographer, the landscape photographer, Retouching artists, you know, those digital retouching artists, they're going to immensely benefit from this piece of hardware. As on today, the product is being retailed in Europe for about 199 euros, around 21,000 Indian rupees in India. And I am sure it's only an introductory price. I would like to end this video by making a small request to LoupeDeck. That is, make this compatible with the Adobe Premiere Pro 2, unless you are planning it already. That'll be fantastic. Suddenly, this is going to open up a whole new world for the editor. He can really grade his image and much more intuitively, much more organically using a tool like this. So, looking forward to that. Bye for now.
Okay, cut.
Yaar, I don't want to leave now, yeah? I want to continue playing with this. It's so addictive.
Lights off.
Hey, come on guys, yeah, give me a break, yeah.